Hello friends, it's Sunday evening and Sunday evenings are for story pills. A single mom has 7 kids and when her oldest one, a girl, went to school, she found out that the teacher told her she wasn't allowed to pray over her lunch. So this single mom, who didn't even have a high school diploma, pulled her daughter out of school to homeschool her. And this was back before homeschooling was as popular as it is now. It wasn't official back then either. They were subject to harassment from the school. The school bus would wait outside and lay on the horn every morning. The bus driver would yell, grunt, and sometimes even get out and come beat on the door. The school would call all the time and the woman stopped answering the phone. She finally got what she had feared for a long time. An official letter saying she had to go to court for her daughter's truancy. She was shocked as she read the letter. She couldn't believe what she was reading and she let the letter fall out of her hand in despair. Her daughter came up and asked her if it was bad news. She said yes, and the daughter asked if she could read the letter. Since it was about her, the mom let her read the letter, and without the mom noticing right away, the 6-year-old girl had pulled out a red pen and begun to circle several grammatical and spelling errors in the letter. Her mom scolded her, saying she wasn't supposed to do that to other people's papers. She had done that to her daughter's papers as she taught her at home. So, she went to court and she took the letter with her to make sure she went to the right place. When she was before the judge, he asked her if she knew what she was there for. She handed him the letter. She had forgotten about the markings. She figured he would ask her a bunch of questions about her own education and conclude she was unfit to homeschool her daughter and order her to go to school. But the judge looked at the letter and he asked, "Who put these markings?" She told him her daughter had and was apologizing. The judge took off his glasses and looked back at the letter. He told her, "Well, the reason you are here today is that it is suspected that your daughter is not being properly educated. However, it appears that she is being educated, and from what I see here, it is clearly not coming from the public schools. This case is dismissed." She hadn't realized it, but she had taught her first grade daughter to a 7th grade reading level. You see, disappointment can become a blessing. Don't give in to persecution because you fear what will become of you. God always stands by those who trust Him.